At 10 a.m. this morning, more than 1,000 students gathered and staged an on-campus peaceful protest march and demanded the removal of George Koroi as the university's bursar. The police were called into the campus to maintain order. The boycott followed on from last week Thursday, after students were told that there was a 60% increase to their tuition fees. It's understood at least three letters of inquiry submitted to the bursar by the Student Representative Council concerning the issue were ignored.
And today we march up and they did not want to address us. The acting vice chancellor, bursar, they ran away in front of us.
Today the students protested to the administration block and locked the main door to the bursar's office after it failed to address the students in a forum. On Friday last week, the acting vice chancellor, Dr. Samson Laup, released a statement stating that the boycott is illegal and that students must return to class, and he said there won't be any adjustments made to the academic programs as a result of the boycott. But the students today showed no signs of returning to class. They called on the Office of Higher Education for immediate intervention.
And this situation urgently requires the intervention of the Department of Higher Education. The minister and the governing council must come and intervene in this situation now, or else something different will happen.
It's understood the Minister for Higher Education, Malachy Tabar, is in Goruka to attend to the UOG issue, and he is expected to talk to the UNRE students tomorrow to address their concerns. Edwin Fidelis, National MTV News, Kokopo.